So with regards to Snapchat, you said before that you did Snapchat message back and forth with Jonathan.
I did.
All right. And primarily, is that in the week after you asked for a divorce from Armando, or does that include before?
No, that was after.
That was after?
Yes.
So this is just within the week, within the 7 days before Jonathan died?
Yes.
How did you two communicate during that week?
First it was Facebook, and then he said he didn't like Facebook, so we started text messaging each other, just SMS, and then we moved to Snapchat.
And do you remember who set up that Snapchat conversation, him or you?
I don't remember who initiated that.
You said before that there's a thing about Snapchat messages kind of disappear after you read them unless you change the settings.
Yes.
Do you know who set the settings for your conversation with Jonathan that week before he died?
He set the settings for 24 hours.
24 hours. So what does that mean? In real world terms, what does that mean?
So in the messages, they won't disappear until 24 hours have passed. Once 24 hours hits, they're gone. But in that time, you can go back because there's a lot of frustration with leaving it as it disappears, because you can open it, and if you don't read it or if you don't see it and you get out of the app or you have to close your phone, you lose the message. Or if you're busy and you read it and then get out of it, you can't remember what you were talking about before. So.
And with that, you continue to communicate with him even though that was the setting?
Yes.
I believe you said before that you were logging out of your phone at this time?
I was.
Yeah. Why were you doing that? Explain that for the jury.
I didn't want Armando to see that I was talking to a guy.
Did you ever go with John or see John outside of work that week before he died?
Yes, I did.
How many times?
Once.
Where did you guys go?
There was a park in Peterborough, Edward McDowell, something like that. It was like a dam. And we went and we parked and talked about work and the people that we worked with and his boss. And
what time of day was this that you guys went and did this?
It was between 3 and 4.
3 and 4 in the afternoon?
In the afternoon, yes.
All right, so this is after your shift gets over with?
Right after work, yeah.
Okay. I did take it 3 or 4 afternoons, I'm going to assume daylight outside?
Yes.
What did you explain to him about your relation? I'm sorry, what did you explain to him about what relationship you were looking for? What did you say to him about that?
I said I couldn't offer anything more than friendship. I said, I don't mind getting to know you, like you're a very nice person, but I don't even know if I like you, you know, at this point. I don't know what kind of music you listen to. I don't know if you can, like, if I can just be around you as a friend, you know what I mean? So, like, I don't mind getting to know you, but I can't promise you anything more than that.
Was it in your mind, when you said stuff like this, were you these questions that you had that you wanted answered before to see whether or not to start a relationship with him?
I'm sorry, can you repeat the question?
Were these questions that were in your mind, what music you listened to, getting to know him, were you asking these questions because in your mind you were thinking about maybe starting a relationship with him?
I thought there might have been potential, but I wasn't planning on a relationship.
Okay. Did you tell him that you were, at the time that you had asked for a divorce from Armando before you met him, met with him and went out to McDowell Park?
I did.
So you knew that?
Yes.
Okay. Did you state to him that you felt like you needed to get to know him first?
Yes.
Okay. How is it that you managed to get away from not going home right after work to go out on that one time to the park?
So that week, I decided to do overtime, which I did do overtime Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday. Fridays, I did not do any overtime. And Wednesday, we made plans to go and just hang out and talk.
How did you guys get there?
He drove.
Did you have your family car? And what car did you drive most of the time?
I drove the Jeep most of the time.
Did you drive to work that day, or did somebody drop you off?
I drove to work that day.
So where did you leave your Jeep?
In the parking lot at Teleflex.
Where? At the back employee entrance or on the side?
On the side, where I would normally park.
And why did you guys take his car to go to the park?
Because if Armando showed up, then he would see that my car was still in the parking lot.
Who picked that location for you guys to meet? Or to go to, excuse me.
He did. We really didn't know what we were going to do. And he's like, do you just want to go to a park? And I'm like, I really don't care, you know, whatever. So he was like, okay. And then he just started driving. And then we ended up at Edward McDowell.
After you met, you sat with him there at the park and you guys are talking.
Yes.
What was so special about Jonathan?
He was very kind. He was very sweet. Like, he was really funny. And, like, he didn't show that on the floor because he was in professional mode, but he was really funny.
How was he different when you were in person with him here at the park? When you say he's in professional mode?
Yeah, like, he doesn't really joke around and he doesn't really talk very much if it's not about work. And, like, seeing his personality outside of work, I was like, man, you're really cool. You're a really cool guy.
So, were there other people at the park while you were meeting with him there?
I think there was one other car parked there.
Okay. And you guys were just in a parking lot?
Yeah.
How did Jonathan get you back to Teleflex?
He drove me back.
And is this his car?
Yes.
Is that the Subaru, you know?
Impreza, yeah.
At the end of that time together when you were at the park, was there any physical touching or interaction between the two of you?
Yeah, so when he dropped me off outside the big parking lot, the main employee entrance.
The one in the back?
Yes.
Okay.
And
why there?
Because I didn't want Armando to see, like, if Armando ended up showing up, I didn't want him to see that I was being dropped off by anybody. Like, I was supposed to be at work.
Okay. So when he drops you off, where do you go?
Straight inside, and then I went out to the other exit and went to my car. Like.
Okay. So let me go back to my other question. Was there any kind of physical interaction between you and Jonathan at the end of that trip to the park?
Yes. I kissed him.
Where were you guys when you kissed him?
Right outside the door.
Right outside the employee door there?
Yes.
At the back?
He was in the driver's seat and I was in the passenger. And I said, I'm going to kiss you right now. And he leaned forward. And I, like, literally gave him a peck. And then I was like, I ran away like a little. I was just, like, so embarrassed. I was like, I don't know what I just did.
Felt awkward.
Yeah, like, it was just like a little peck, and then I was like, I'm okay, and like got out of that car as soon as possible.
Was there any other time that you guys, and that's on Wednesday?
Yes.
16th?
Yes.
Was there any other time that you guys had ever kissed?
Yes.
When?
Friday. That Friday morning, we had break in his car.
Tell us about that.
We were just talking, and we were talking about work. We had a new automotive part that was on the line that he was working on and trying to get up and running. And then he just leaned over and he kissed me.
How was that?
Different than the first time. It was longer. It wasn't just a peck.